Hey guys, it's Lance at Mac Sound Solutions, and today I did a $20 upgrade to my Mac Pro 5.1, and it's probably the best 20 bucks. It definitely is the best 20 bucks, because most things cost more than that, that I've spent on my Mac Pro. My Mac Pro lives in the closet over here next to, you know, on the other side of my mixing board, so I don't hear the sounds it's making when I'm mixing. And I always had trouble with my Bluetooth signal, and I love using a trackpad. I have the original Apple Magic trackpad. So that was always like, you know, the cursor would just randomly move all over the screen. If I plop my phone next to it, it would go completely bonkers. So then I went out and got one of these little dongles, and it worked for a while, but the problem was it would like disconnect, and then I'd be connected back to the Mac Pro's Bluetooth card. And so I wanted to do something that's going to be a permanent fix. And I know you can go out there and you can buy these newer, faster Wi-Fi cards with Bluetooth right on the same card. That install is more difficult though. I use Ethernet because I have gigabit internet, so I don't use Wi-Fi. Just hard, you know, hardwired to my router. So I found this kit on Amazon, cost $20. You could probably outsource all the parts yourself for maybe $10. But, you know, it was just the right length of cable and everything for me. So I just ponied up the 20 bucks. And I highly recommend it, because if you're having Bluetooth issues, this, you can put the antenna anywhere you want it. It's sitting on my desk right in front of my trackpad, so it's great. You know, I haven't had any signal issues since I've done this. I can plop my phone right next to my trackpad with Bluetooth and Wi-Fi on, and it doesn't disturb it in any way. I'll show you how I did the install. First, you want to unplug your computer from any power supply. Also, discharge any static electricity that might be on your body, or use one of those little straps that keeps you from shocking your computer. And then you want to slide out your processor tray. Put it somewhere safe, and then lay your Mac Pro on its back so it's flat instead of standing up. So here's a shot of where the Bluetooth card is located. The Wi-Fi is more in the front of the computer. And the Bluetooth is in the lower right-hand side behind the CPU tray. Okay, so now that the Mac Pro is lying flat on its back, we can look down and see the Bluetooth card and the little gold connector that we want to remove from the card. The connector is very tiny, so basically you just want to get your hand down in there, grab the actual gold connector, and maybe put your fingernails under there a little bit and just slowly pry it up, sort of a back and forth motion, and it will unclip itself. And here's a shot of it disconnected. Now you want to wrap a little tape around it, electrical tape, so it doesn't short out anything on the board, because you're just leaving it sort of dangling in the computer. I also removed my graphics card because to fit my hand in there to get the new bay door into its slot and feed its cable underneath the GPU to get it to the card would have been pretty much impossible. So you gotta pull out your graphics card before you put in the new cable. And the first thing you wanna do now is, once your graphics card is out, is to put this in place, and the wire should be facing into the computer, and it should go in the third PCIe bay door slot. And here it is installed, and you can see that the wire, although it's kind of hanging over the second empty PCIe slot, it actually wraps around the first PCIe slot, and I taped it down to the logic board so it wouldn't get in the way when I'm putting the graphics card back in. And then I fed the little gold connector that's like the one we removed into the area where the Bluetooth card is. And you don't want to put your graphics card back in there until you're done with the install of the antenna. Okay, so the trickiest part of the whole install is this right here. You don't want to use any extra force, but you do have to use a little to get it to snap in. And my suggestion is to line it up exactly the way your old cable was connected. Don't try and put it in at a different angle. I tried that and it didn't work. I thought it was just a circle and it would snap in, but no, there's actually a little indentation there. So you have to line it up the same way the old cable was on, which in my case was at about 3 o'clock. And then once you think you got it lined up, you push down and it should snap into place. Just don't try and push it too hard if it's not snapping into place, and just line it up and try it again. Just take your time and be patient. There's no rush. You don't want to bend the connector or the receiver on the board. It will snap in and you'll go, ah, I got it. So one thing I didn't mention before, as you can see, there's a little clip that the old wire was underneath and then connected to the board. So I removed it from that clip. I guess I could have left the old wire clip down there or clipped the new wire on the clip, but it was nicely solidly connected and it's coming into the logic board at a different angle, so I didn't want to put it under the clip and then cause it to pop off the board. So I left it as is. So final step is to connect the long antenna extension cable to the outside of your computer. At the connector there, and then put the other end wherever is closest to your trackpad or your mouse. In my case, I just put it on my desk, and he gives you a little antenna, which you screw onto the end of the extension cable that you're going to put on your desk or wherever is close to your trackpad or mouse. Thankfully, they gave me a black one instead of this ugly beige one, and you're done. Power your 5.1 back up, and you'll be in Bluetooth heaven. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. Give me the thumbs up or the thumbs down, and hit that little bell icon so you get a notification next time I upload a video. We'll see you on the next Mac Sound Solutions video.